These days, your calendar is supercharged, and you find yourself having to pencil in when you need to breathe. As we're always moving and grooving between our offices, home, studio, and out, we could all take some moments to spend time and hear from our faves in pop culture on what they're up to and how they keep it together as well. I'm your host, Kimmy Smith, a celeb fashion stylist, co-founder and creative style director of Athleisure Mag, co-executive producer and host of a number of shows in our multimedia podcast network, Athleisure Studio. When you plug into Bungalow SK, you'll get to hang out with those that, regardless of their background, are juggling their busy lives and have words of empowerment to keep us motivated throughout our day. On today's episode of Bungalow SK, we're so excited to talk to Brad Goreski. When we first met him on Bravo's The Rachel Zoe Project, he stepped into the world of styling and being her assistant. He continued on with the network with It's a Brad Brad World and appearing on a number of shows, including being a co-host on E! Fashion Police for a number of seasons and during awards season on E! Live from the Red Carpet, where he gives the inside scoop on who is dressed, who is wearing what, and making predictions on what designers we will see on the red carpets. His career has included being a creative director at Kate Spade and dressing a number of coveted celebs, including Emily Ratajkowski, Demi Moore, Rashida Jones, and Jessica Alba, to name a few. So when did you realize that you wanted to work in fashion and ultimately become a stylist?
I think I knew from a very young age. I always loved fashion and putting outfits together for myself and for my mom. And I was always so aware of what everybody was wearing that I feel like, you know, this is kind of exactly what I was supposed to be doing. But the real turning point was when I was in college and I was looking for a summer internship and I landed one at Vogue in New York. And the rest is kind of history. I just knew it was where I wanted to be. I feel very lucky that I've been able to work in an industry that has been so welcoming to me for many, many years now.
When it comes to styling your clients, where do you go for inspiration and how does that process start?
Social media, I think, is such a great place to get inspired. There's everything from the past, present, and the future available to us there. So, you know, I follow, obviously, a variety of different people and different pages, and it's so fun to, you know, see an image. I just saw an old image of Marilyn Monroe the other day in this great, like, black lace blouse and pencil skirt and heels and just the whole vibe of the setup. I was like, I have to do that on one of my clients this summer because it was just such a beautiful summery look. And you know, there's so many great trends this summer as well that it's fun to keep up on social media.
What are three trends that we should be incorporating into our summer look?
Well, one of the big trends that I'm loving for summer, for men and for women, is really bright, bold colors. So whether that's like a bright red or a royal blue or even like something as crazy as a bright yellow, thinking about bold color is one of my favorite trends. So you can do that in suiting, you could do that in a blazer, you could do it in shorts. The second one is florals. Florals are everywhere right now, whether it's a bigger floral or, you know, more of like a micro floral, a smaller one. I think that florals for men and for women are a really nice summery way to kind of add a little bit of interest to your wardrobe. And of course, number three is always having a good pair of sunglasses. I'm so happy to be partnering with the Vision Council to be talking about sunglasses and protecting your eyes this summer and also the best ways that you can purchase a pair of sunglasses and, you know, some of the steps that you can go through to thinking about, you know, when you're buying a pair of sunglasses, to always think about protecting your eyes. So you want to protect yourself from UVA and UVB rays. So you're going to look for that little sticker that we're all familiar with on the sunglasses that you're purchasing. Then number two is you're going to want to think about comfort and fit. So getting a pair of sunglasses that really suits the shape of your face and feels comfortable on your face. Then three, thinking about your lifestyle. Like, what do you do throughout the day? Are you super active? Are you running errands? Are you picking up the kids? And then number four is your style. So what's your style this summer? Are you looking more towards like a Marilyn Monroe style, which might be a little bit more vintage, like a cat eye? Or are you maybe a little bit more classic and wanting to do like an aviator?
Interestingly enough, there are a number of people who don't wear sunglasses for a number of reasons, whether it's misconceptions or them just not understanding why they need to wear them. What do you think those are?
Yeah, you know, I think there are a lot of myths out there about sunglasses. You know, I think sometimes people, you know, believe that if it's cloudy outside that they're not getting any UV exposure, and you actually are. You know, it doesn't matter whether it's cloudy or whether it's sunny, there's always the risk of UVA, UVB exposure. I think also when people look at their sunglasses, if they have like a super dark lens in them, they think that they're getting protection. The only way you know if you're getting protection against UVA, UVB is if it has that little sticker. So you're going to want to look for that for sure. You know, I think the Vision Council says it's really important whenever you're outside during the day to be protecting your eyes with a pair of sunglasses.
As someone that I am sure travels quite a lot, what are three items that are in your carry-on that those are always your go-tos and they just make traveling that much easier?
Very good question, because I'm taking off on a flight this afternoon. So, okay, so number one are snacks. I always have to have snacks with me. I have to have my own little, because I like to eat on the airplane. It gets me through. So I always have like some bars, a little treat. I like to carry some almond butter and stuff with me. I always have earplugs with me as well, because I like a lot of quiet. And I have to have my headphones with me at all times.
So a few weeks ago, the Met Gala took place, and obviously you were on E! Live for the red carpet talking about a lot of the looks. So what were three of your favorite looks that took place during this past Met Gala, which focused on notes on camp?
Ooh, that's a good question. I am going to say I loved Cardi B and Tom Brown. I loved Katy Perry and the Moschino chandelier. And I love Emily Ratajkowski in Dundas, I believe it was.
Thanks for joining us on today's episode of Bungalow SK. Make sure to follow us on your favorite podcast platforms, including Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google Play, SoundCloud, and Stitcher Premium. Bungalow SK is a member of the multimedia podcast network at Leisure Studio, part of Athleisure Media and Athleisure Mag. You can see our show notes at athleisurestudio.com/bungalow-sk and follow us on Instagram at bungalow.sk to find out who we're talking with as well as what our guests are up to. I'm your host, Kimmy Smith, and I'll see you next time at Bungalow SK.